to the transcript.
Biden's plan to reverse former President Donald Trump's harsh immigration policies have hit further roadblocks. On Tuesday, a federal judge indefinitely blocked the Biden administration from enforcing a 100-day moratorium on most deportations.
A Food and Drug Administration review confirmed Wednesday that Johnson & Johnson's COVID-19 vaccine, which only requires a single shot, is safe and effective, meaning it could be authorized for emergency approval by this weekend.
On Tuesday, the Amherst Pelham Regional School Committee adopted a resolution promising in-person instruction when schools reopen after summer break. The resolution states that schools within the school district will provide full-time in-person learning for the full 2021 to 2022 school year for all students.
I'm Max Cowan.
And I'm Finn Steiniger.
Welcome to Hampton!
Y'all ready for this?
On Monday, NHS student athletes representing various sports took to City Hall to protest the hiatus of their Fall 2 sports season. Many were frustrated by the lack of representation during the Board of Health meetings, in which the city's public health director, Meredith O'Leary, chose not to include the Fall 2 sports season on their agenda, with nearly a week until what would be the first football practice. Hamped Up was on the scene at the protests to understand the perspectives of the players.
I'm here in downtown Northampton in front of City Hall with
Brett Holden
and
Seth Finnessy
to talk about their jeopardized senior seasons due to COVID-19.
What is the goal of this protest?
The goal of this protest is to let people know that the athletes care and that we want our season.
Yeah, exactly. Just to let the city know and let everyone know that we want to play and that we should be playing along with every other school around us, and we're willing to take any precautions.
How beneficial are sports to teenagers?
Some of us, sports are the only thing they have, and that's what they look forward to every day. And if that one sport's getting canceled, then that sucks a lot. And like I said earlier, it means a lot to us, so that's why we're here.
What are your thoughts on other teams being able to play, but not you guys?
I honestly think it's just ridiculous. Like, girls soccer played, boys soccer played, golf played. I'll wear 10 masks if I have to, with a ski mask. Like, I'll wear a face guard. I do not care. I will do anything to be able to play my last football season ever. This means the world to me, and it means the world to everyone behind me.
Great. Thank you, guys.
This protest has expanded to an argument between two sides of the school. One side in support of the protest and in the opportunity to play sports, and the other side critical of the nature of the protest in the current context of world affairs. As a result of the ridicule that spilled over into online forums, an email response was sent by Superintendent John Provost to the Northampton community. We spoke to Athletic Director Lauren McFarland to get some insight into the situation.
What's your take on the ridicule protesting students faced online?
I think the ridicule makes me very sad. I think our football athletes were trying to speak up for equity. We are truly the only school in all of Western Mass that is not playing. And I think we have been stuck in COVID exhaustion for a really long time. And every type of student and person has lost their outlet. And so people are exhausted and they're mad, and they're going to take out their frustration wherever they can. So for the students, people, and adults who were upset at the football players, and for the football players who responded poorly, I think it's because all of our outlets are gone, and it's tough and it's sad. And I think everybody deserves better right now, and we haven't been able to offer it. So I think it's a deeper issue than just football. Honestly, I really do.
What are your thoughts on the Fall 2 season? Head over to Transcript NHS on Instagram to let us know what you think in this week's poll. Thank you for watching. See you next week.
Trump once again avoided conviction by the U.S. Senate on Saturday the 13th. The final tally was 57-43, which left the prosecution 10 short of the two-thirds majority required. Trump is still eligible to run for president again in 2024 if he so chooses.
This week, we spoke to people in downtown Northampton to hear their perspectives on the results of the impeachment trial and what they think is next for former President Donald Trump.
Twitter suspending Trump's account, do you think his popularity will die down or will he remain in the spotlight?
I think that it will die down, but I think some very dangerous seeds have been sown. And so I think it's a good thing ultimately, but I think a lot of damage has already been done.
Do you think he's going to run for political office again?
I don't think that he will, but I think he's, again, set up a lot of people in his footsteps to pick up where he left off.
How has former President Trump's actions influenced the political atmosphere in the United States?
I think it's made a lot more Republicans like really scared to go against him and disagree with his views because he's been really controlling. And I also think it's made a lot more hatred in the atmosphere of politics and torn a lot of people apart.
What do you think is next for Donald Trump?
I hope that he goes away for a long, long time and is super quiet. But I think it's also important to recognize that he is a symptom of a systemic problem. So while Donald Trump, the person, might go away, the relevant issues that were very connected to his presidency are not going to go away.
How has former President Trump's actions influenced the political atmosphere in the United States?
I think his actions have made it a lot more volatile right now. I think they have also brought to light some things that should have been brought to light, like Black Lives Matter, a long time ago. Maybe it wasn't brought around the right way, but because of his actions, it did happen and it did come out. And I think that we are in store for a better country now.
Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. See you next week.
Ayo, welcome to the other stuff. This week, we're bored, with nothing new and exciting happening in many months. We've noticed that even the most extreme introverts are at their wits' ends and just want to go outside and see others. With this in consideration, we give you our complete list on how to deal with quarantine.
Uno. Winner!